Google UX design certificates were released in 2021 and I took it in 2021. 1 year later, I became a product designer at eBay. And fast forward to today, I'm no longer with eBay because I started my own design company, Aliena Design LLC. Many things have changed in the past few years that make Google certificates less relevant than before, but still relevant enough for beginners. Hey everyone, I'm Aliena and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will break down Google certificates and whether it's relevant this year. Here are some major questions I want to answer first. Is Google UX design certificates job guaranteed? Absolutely not. Just by including the Google certificates on your resume doesn't really increase the chance of getting hired in this competitive time. And in fact, I've seen more and more people just clicking through the certificates in order to get their certificate, which actually decreases its value even more. If you want to take the course, take it for its value and its knowledge. Do not take it for the certificate. Will Google be more open to hire you if you have the Google certificates? Unfortunately, no. Google hires and fires people based on its own timeline. If they are not hiring, then they are not hiring. In fact, when I was interviewing for Google, not a single person in the room even knew that there were Google certificates. Does Google UX design certificates teach you how Google does design? Not exactly. When I was taking the certificates, my biggest incentive was to learn how do big tech companies like Google do design. I even replaced all of my previous clients' projects with my Google certificates' personal projects just to make things look more Google and look more thorough. Now that I have experience working for big tech and now that I have an entire network full of people working in tech, I can tell you that Google UX certificates will teach you the theoretical and academic way of doing design, which is in the ideal world, the best thing to do. But that factors out a lot of real-life elements. And tech companies each uses a slightly different way to do design. If you are interested in exploring more about UX design and not yet fully committed to this career transition, I think Google UX design is good for you. It is affordable and it touches on a lot of theories, techniques, and knowledge you need to know as a designer. It breaks things down into bite-sized pieces, like 2 to 5 minute videos. So it makes perfect sense if you're a full-time student or if you have a full-time job and want to take this part-time. I especially think Certificate 1 to Certificate 5 are very good for you. The content is spot on. And it will take you through doing one personal project for a mobile app using Figma. So take Course 1 to 5. Course 6 will ask you to use Adobe XD, but something that happened after the release of the certificate is that Figma became the design monopoly of design tools space, so use Figma, don't use Adobe XD. And Course 6 and Course 7 each requires you to do one more additional project, so that's very time consuming. You can just scan through it or skip it. And if you want to take the certificate, I highly recommend the Coursera Plus plan, because it not only gives you the access to this certificate, but there's also tons of Coursera courses out there that you can take. For example, Google also has its data analysis program and project management program, which I both took, and they've both helped me in a very unexpected way. The link of that is in the description. Now, if you are very serious about transitioning into UX design, then I'll make it clear that just taking Google UX design certificate is not enough. Here's my story. I started by doing physical product design, like designing chairs and desks. Then I did a UI design paper on smart home product, like, you know, Alexa to control the lights and stuff. Then I learned design thinking from Stanford D School. Then I worked for Stanford D School as a design intern. Then I did a UI design internship in a startup in Tokyo. Then I did a product design internship in a Silicon Valley startup. Then I did a paper on brain computer interface UX design, like the Neuralink thing Elon Musk is doing. And finally, I did the Google UX design certificate. And after that, I did another design contractor role at a mortgage company. And then I started my personal brand, which is this YouTube channel. And after all that, I got a senior design contractor role at eBay. So please be patient and adopt to a growth mindset. This journey is not a 3 month journey. Even if you see a lot of YouTube videos saying that how they break into UX design in 3 months, there is a lot behind that story. So I don't think it's rational to expect that one program can make you a UX designer. I'm especially talking about becoming a UX designer or product designer in big tech companies. In the United States, you can earn from $100K to $400K per year working as a UX or product designer at big tech companies. I think Netflix pays the most. If you want to know the step-by-step process of what you need to learn to become a designer in big tech company right now, I have a PDF guide. It is free in the description. You can grab that. And after you download the PDF, you will automatically be put into my email list. So you will hear from me from my email list as well. Let's say you finish the Google UX Design Certificates. What are some knowledge gaps you need to fill in between the certificate and getting a job? First is UI design skill and Figma. When a recruiter decides whether or not to hire you, they will open up your portfolio and they will scan through the project banner, which includes the UI design of your project. If that UI banner has some major issue, you are immediately denied. And most designers I've seen graduating from Google UX certificates have some major UI design issues because this course doesn't focus on UI design. You may be using accent color in the wrong spot. You may have multiple call to action in the same page. A lot of people also use a body font size that is just way too large, or you have a problem aligning everything. I have a free Figma tutorial playlist that you can follow, so if you want to level up your Figma skill, check here. This is the free version. Of course, there's also a paid version, which I will talk about it later. Second is product thinking and business sense. Most tech companies are calling their designers product designers these days, because at the end of the day, a designer designs for the product. Your title is whatever your company wants to call their designers. Whether you are called a UI, UX, product, web, interaction designer, at the end of the day, you need to design something. You need to deliver a Figma file that solves the user problem and help the business to generate more annual revenue. All of my projects in eBay are related to pay-per-click advertising at eBay, and if I can't think business, I won't get a job. Third is client project. It's very obvious that junior design positions are close to non-existence right now. And this is not just happening in the design industry. It is happening everywhere. Economic downturns plus the rise of AI will make junior positions less and less common. This is not something we can control. So instead of complaining about it, let us focus on something that we can control. In a time like this, it is crucial to use networking skills and personal branding to attract client projects first. After working on a few client projects, you can position yourself as a senior designer and compete in the senior contractor design market. Fourth is portfolio. Google UX certificates provide you a template that you can follow for your portfolio, but I do not recommend using that template. That template is more like writing an essay. It lists out everything from top to bottom, from start to finish of what you've done. It's an essay, it's not a pitch. A good design portfolio is a pitch. And you also need to pitch your portfolio to business stakeholders who have very little time and patience and may not even understand UX design. You need to make your portfolio and case study strong and concise instead of a list of everything you can do. And of course, I have a video on that. It's right here. It's a little bit advanced, but I think my audience, you guys, are okay with it. Finally, is there any course similar to Google certificates that's more relevant today? Absolutely yes! You shall check out Fast Track UX. It's designed for people who are serious about transitioning into UX design. This is a course developed by me, and I will teach you how design is done in big tech companies, not in theories. I will also show you what it's like to go into a meeting room where you are the designer, and then there's also other stakeholders like a PM, an engineer, and someone from the leadership. It will take you through basic and advanced Figma skills, and also take you through one project of your choice. You will not use a prompt generator. You will choose a project of your own based on your strength. And by the end, you will have a portfolio that looks like a pitch and have a marketing strategy for yourself to attract your first client project so that in 1 to 3 years, you can become a senior designer in big tech companies. This course pretty much fills in the gap of Google certificate, design bootcamps, and many master programs out there. I know this because I'm either the promoter or a guest lecturer of all these programs. And I just finished producing every single episode in Fast Track UX. And right now, it is priced at a Japanese watermelon. It will only go up from here. So if you want to unlock things you cannot learn from YouTube and unlock a community where you can ask for co-working partners and design feedback, the best time to enroll is right now. Link in the description. Transitioning my career from software engineering to UX design is the best design decision. The best decision I've ever made. And I only see myself doing more design in the age of AI and content economy. There is endless possibilities in the design field today, but it probably will make more sense after we wait for 10 years and then look backward. And then we'll be like, we haven't done that. As always, I'm Aliena. Follow me for more design and business related content. The link to Coursera Plus, my free PDF guide, and also my course is in the description. If you like this video, You will also like this video, and I will see you in this video. Bye!